English. Thermal burns. Contact electric burns. Chemical burns and radiation burns. In our lecture, we speak about thermal burns. So, classification. Thermal, chemical, electrical, and radiation burns. In clinic, there are some variety between thermal, chemical, electrical, and radiation burns, but pathogenesis and the principle of treatment are similar. Damage of tissue is denaturation of protein and the temperature through whole of human tissue variability is approximately 45 degrees Celsius. If tissue overheating occurs at temperature below 58 degrees Celsius, we get wet necrosis. And if temperature above 65 degrees Celsius, we get coagulation necrosis, coagulation. And clinical picture of the patient's skin are very different. In each case, doctor must solve three problems. Doctor must solve, determine the square of burns, the deep of burns, and prognosis. And prognosis. Given the depth of the lesion, first stage, epidermal lesion, second stage, damage to the epithelium, to the derm line, third stage, damage to the dermis. 3A, necrosis of epithelium and partial on the growth zone with the preservation of the follicles, subanus, and sweat glands. Third B, necrosis of entire thickness of the dermis, germline, partially subcutaneous tissue. And Four stage necrosis of interior thickness of the skin and deep tissue. The picture. First stage, second stage, third A, third B, and fourth stage. It is fundamentally important when determining treatment tactic and assisting a burn patient to determine. Burn depth, burn area, and predict burn severity. A fundamentally important issue for self-healing of burn wound in the allocation of bone of third A and third B degrees. One, two, and three A degrees are superficial burns and can heal independently without the use of skin plastics. Clinic. Superficial burns. The diagnosis is very easy for each doctor. During examination, you may make diagnosis. Burns of 3B and 4 degree too deep, requiring surgical restoration of the skin. The deep burns. Burns area determination. We know the rule 9. What does it mean? Each part of the body we may share to 9 square. The head, 18%, the chest, 9% femur, hand and and the whole 100%. Assessment of severity of the burn is primarily based on the determination of the total area of the burn and area of deep damage. Attention is also paid to the state of the respiratory tract. Science burn of this era is equal in severity of the G burn of 10% of the body surface. And total, the square, the area of burns may be more than 100%. Burn area determination. The palm area is 1 or 1.2% of the body surface and may use that method.
Sir, could you please previous slide for 1 minute?
Okay.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Okay. Prognosis. Prediction of burn severity. In adults, is rule frame matters. Hundredth rule. Age plus total burn area in percent up to 70. The forecast is favorable. 61 to 80. Relatively favorable. $81 to $1,000, doubtful, and more unfavorable. Unfavorable. But sometimes you cannot know the age of patient, and in that method you cannot know about deep of the burn, but that information is very important for doctors, and we sometimes use another method for prognosis, Frankel index. The Frankel index is based on the assumption that deep burn triple aggravates the condition of the patient compared to the superficial burns. Therefore, if 1% of superficial burns is equal to 1 unit, then a deep burn to 3 units. So the sum of the indication of superficial and deep burns is the Frankel index. Frankel index. Frankel index, the formula, is the sum. Burn prognosis. Favorable is the Frankel index is less than 30 units. Relatively favorable. favorable. 30, 60 units. Doubtful. 61, 90 units. And finally, unfavorable, more than 90 units. Students, it's a very easy method, but that method is possible to determine prognosis of the patients and classification patient for the different group. Superficial burns, the clinic, let's try to determine prognosis of that patient. Who are ready? Student. Dear student, who are ready to determine prognosis of that patient? That patient dead or maybe he will alive? Okay, it's so difficult for you. Okay, let's start. So, 9%, 18%, 4.5%. The age is about 50 and total burn area 46% and prognosis is doubtful, unfortunately. The deep burns. Necrosis is the area of necrosis. Coagulation necrosis. The temperature of damage is more than 65 degrees Celsius. So, burn disease. The burn disease is a complex of clinical symptoms developing as a result of thermal damage to the skin and underlying tissue. Burn disease develops with superficial burns second stage, third A degree with the eye area of more than 15% of body surface and deep burns more than 10%. During a burn disease, four periods are distinguished. The first period is burn shock. The second period, acute burn toxemia. The next period, septicotoxemia. Fourth period, convalescence. Convalescence. Burn shock the hallmarks of burn shock are severity of erective fast, duration of the cause, presence of oliguria. Very important information. With the burn of 30% of the body surface and the patient weight of 70 kilograms, 5, maybe 6 liters are lost with evaporation and 7 liters of fluid per day with edema. The deficit of circulation blood volume relative to the initial one of the indicated burn value is 20% in the first hour after the injury and 30% after 3 hours. Burn shock pathogenesis. The first, outflow of plasma proteins into the intracellular space. Outflow of plasma proteins into the intracellular space. Changes in the functional properties of the walls of blood vessels. Hemolysis, up to 20, maybe 30% of circulation red blood cells is destroyed on the first day. Redistribution of sodium ions. Burn dips. BCC decreases due to both plasma loss and deposition of blood and its hemolysis. It's some main principle of genesis of Byon Shog. Features of pathogenesis of Byon Shog are pain syndrome, plasma loss, a leading pathogenesis factor, microcirculation disorders due to the accumulation of other active substance, histamine, serotonin, and so on in the burn area. And finally, blood thickening. In normal the fluid located in vessels after burn disease, the water located in extracellular area, extracellular space. Wilkinson's is divided into 3 degrees. The first degree easy, second degree heavy, and third degree extremely difficult. The first degree. Burn area about 20%. Deep no more than 10% of body surface. Pulse 90-100 heart rate. Blood pressure normal. Temperature normal of subfebrile. Oliguria up to 30 milliliters per hour. In normal. What about normal? More than 30 milliliters per hour. Hemoglobin concentration, hemoglobin 1050 and 150 70 up to 50%. Gematocrite. Second degree, heavy area above 30%, deep no more than 20%. Pulse, blood pressure, hypotension, tachypus. Oliguria less than 30 milliliters per hour. Hemoconcentration, hemoglobin 180 to 200. Hematocrite up to 60-80%. Third degree, extremely difficult. Area, as usual, 60%. Deep burns more than 40%. Pulse over 120. Blood pressure, severe hypertension. Pronounced tachypus, tachypnoia is the Latin. Oliguria less than 30 milliliters per hour. High gamma concentration, hemoglobin more than 240. Hematocrite more than 80%. Red blood cells more than 7 and 7.5. Third degree extremely difficult. Pronounced acidosis develops. Renal function is severely impaired, which is expressed in oligo and anuria. Diuresis per day may be about 2,000-3,000 milliliters. Permanent hematuria, albuminuria, hemoglobin, and urobilinuria. Acute burn toxemia. Last 7 or 8 days, as usual, beings with increase in body temperature. The tone of fluid to the vascular bed and with intoxic substance leased on the one hand to the restoration of hemodynamic parameters and of the other pronounced intoxication, as evidenced by tachycardia, heart rate, dull heart sound, anemia, hyper- and dysproteinemia, impaired function, liver and kidney failure. Septicotoxemia. Characterized by the development of infection. Conditionally, this period stayed from 10 days. The rejection of bone scar beings of 10 days. At which time the heyday of the infection and various purulent septic complications, pneumonia, bed scores, sepsis, and so on, are most pronounced. Complete restoration of the skin indicates the end of the period of septicotoxemia. Convalescence period. Characterized by the normalization of function of organs and systems disturbed during the first three periods of the disease. However, dysfunction of the heart, liver, kidneys, and other organs can also be observed during 2-4 years after injury. Therefore, all severes of bone disease should be constantly registered in dispensary. The treatment of the bone injury patient can be divided into general treatment and local treatment. General treatment is very different in order to bone shock treatment, bone toxemia treatment, septicotoxemia treatment. Local treatment. We distinguish conservative treatment, open treatment, and closed treatment. What does it mean, closed treatment? If we use dressing, is a closed treatment. If we don't use dressing, is open written the word born. The word of the born. Close method, treatment under a bandage. Adventures, this it helps isolate the burn surface. Create optimal condition for the local medical treatment of the burn wounds. Provide more active behavior of patient with significant burns and their transplantation. Its disadvantage are the complexity, high consumption of dressing and thoroughness of dressing. Open treatment. The formation of the dense scab of burn surface is accelerated under influence of the drying effect of air. Ultraviolet exposure. Or lubrication with substance that coagulation of proteins. Or with weight dried dressings. Or as a condition of geobiological environment. Local treatment, surgery. You may use the next method: necrotomy, necrectomy, osteodermoplasty, free skin plastic, non-free skin plastic, and limb amputation, reconstructive, and finally, reconstructive surgery. Indication for early necrectomy are the deep burns of 10, maybe 20% of the body. Autodermoplasty can be performed simultaneously. Burns of the hand, when it is necessary, prevent the formation of gross scars, then violate the function of the limb. the early age of patient to prevent development of infection and more rapid activation of patient. For example, necrosis, remove necrosis, split skin flap plastic. Autodermoplasty. We distinguish free split flap, full layer flap, non-free skin plastic with a flap on the feeding vascular pedicle. Treatment principles. The main task is to restore hemodynamic parameters and replenish fluid loss. The appointment of analgesics and Pelkines to introduction of antihistamines. Improvement of heart activity, cardiac glycosides. Microcirculation improvement. The next. Use in case of fluid replenishment in severe case of shock of hydrocortisone or prednisolone. Oxygen inhalation. Normal kidney function. Early appointment of bacteriophage and staphylococcus toxoid. Infusion transfusion treatment. Finally, antibiotic therapy and immunotherapy. It should be borne in mind that the greatest loss of fluid occurs in the first 8-12 hours and lasts about 2 seconds. With extensive burns, the daily loss of plasma reaches 6 to 8 liters and protein 78 grams or more. There are various formulas for calculating the volume of injected fluid. The main previous of which can be reduced to the following. The amount of transfusion found should not exceed 10% of the patient's body weight. In the first 8 hours after receiving a bone, 1.1, 2, or 2, 3 of the daily volume of fluids is injected. On the second and third days, the volume of injected fluid is not more than 5% of the patient's body weight. We use Brock's formula. 1 milliliter body weight lesion area plus 2,000 milliliters glucose solution plus 5% glucose solution. And 1 degree is not taken in account. You must control effectiveness of treatment. Effectiveness of treatment is monitored based on clinical data, hemoglobin indicators, hematocrites, comparison of CVP, and coronary urine output. That's all.